Vergil was the eldest brother of the twin sons of the dark knight Sparda and Eva. Sometime before his 8th birthday, Eva gave Vergil and his brother Dante each one half of the perfect amulet. It was also around the same time that Sparda disappeared, and Eva and the twins were left alone, only to be attacked by revenge-seeking demons who hoped to harm Sparda's loved ones. Eva was killed, while Vergil and Dante survived the attack. However, the two were separated, and Dante believed Vergil to be dead. 1 year before the events of Devil May Cry 3, Vergil was approached by a mysterious man named Arkham, who told him of the legend of Teddy McGrew, and Vergil agreed to work with Arkham in order to raise the Great Tower in order to seek the power Vergil desired. Over the coming year, Vergil worked with Arkham to break the 7 magical seals that kept Teddy McGrew locked away, and after some time, Arkham and Vergil were successful in breaking the 7 seals, and Teddy McGrew began to rise out from the ground. Vergil then dispatched Arkham to send his brother Dante an invitation to meet him and to see if Dante still had his half of the amulet. And after Dante fought his way up the tower in order to meet up with Vergil once again, the two would engage each other. Vergil managed to defeat Dante quite easily and took his half of the perfect amulet. However, in the process, he caused Dante's demonic powers to awaken, making Dante even more powerful. The two would encounter each other a couple more times that same day and even managed to team up to take down the now demonically empowered Arkham. However, in their final engagement for the time being, Vergil would be defeated by Dante and would be trapped in the demon world. While trapped in the demon world, Vergil would encounter Mudus, the Prince of Darkness, and believing that he could defeat Mudus despite being injured, Vergil engaged Mudus but would be defeated and transformed into Nero Angelo. Years later, Dante would encounter Vergil once again but would defeat him for the final time, gaining possession of Vergil's half of the perfect amulet. Little is known about Nero's origins except that he was raised in the city of Fortuna, and as an orphan was taken in by Curius and Kratos' family. Nero got his name from the black blanket in which he was found, and Sanctus made multiple references that Nero may be a descendant with Sparta's blood. While he was growing up, Nero was taken in by the Order of Swords, which is a religious group that worshipped the Dark Knight Sparta. On the day of the Festival of Blades, while Nero was watching his friend Curie perform, he witnessed the attempted assassination of the Order's leader by the demon hunter Dante. Nero engaged Dante, and it was during their battle that Nero's injured arm suddenly healed and it was discovered that he had access to demonic powers. Using his newly found powers, Nero was able to defeat Dante and force him into a retreat. Nero was then ordered by his friend Kratos to pursue Dante, who was seen heading towards the Order's headquarters. And while on his journey to reach the headquarters, Nero ran into Agnes, the Order's chief alchemist, and Agnes revealed that he created the Hellgates and used them to summon demons, which he needed for his experiments. While in Agnes's lab, Nero discovered the broken sword Yamato, which once belonged to Dante's brother, and using his own demonic powers was able to repair the weapon, thereby unlocking an even greater power within himself. Using Nero's friend Curie as bait, Sanctus lured Nero to a giant statue named the Savior and managed to defeat Nero and take the Yamato sword to form the core of the Savior and absorb Nero into the core. Later on, Dante would recover the Yamato sword and manages to force the Yamato sword through the outer shell of the Savior statue, which awoken Nero from within the Savior's core. With Dante battling the Savior from the outside and Nero battling Sanctus from the inside, the two managed to destroy the Savior once and for all. To solidify their new alliance, Dante allowed Nero to keep the Yamato sword, and in their final moments together, Nero asked if Dante would ever see each other again, and Dante simply vaguely waved back as an answer. What's up again, guys? Brian here at 3TR, and I'm here to share my 6th Versus Series matchup and my 600th video. I would first off like to apologize for the long absence of Versus Series videos. I will explain what's really been going on with me in the real world at the end of the video. But without stalling any longer, it's time for me to pit the Son of Sparda, Vergil, against the man with the demonic arm, Nero. And I will begin by comparing them physically. Vergil is an 18-year-old half-human, half-demon hybrid, and thanks to demonic blood running through his veins, this gives Vergil a series of special physical properties. He has a high durability level, allowing him to take great deals of punishment. He also has superhuman strength, which allows him to deal far more damage to his enemies with very little effort. He also maintains a very high stamina level, allowing him to keep up to a combat peak efficiency for a long period of time. And Vergil also has the ability to move his body in specialized ways exclusive to him, and thanks to his demonic blood, it gives him highly tuned reflexes, and also the ability to move so fast to the point where Vergil could seem to disappear in and out of existence. Vergil also has a healing factor, however, it is not entirely foolproof, as it was shown when Vergil was unable to kill Arkham in Devil May Cry 3, when he explained that if Vergil hadn't taken a beating that very day, he could have cut him into confetti. As far as weaknesses, there really aren't any to point out, except the fact that although he has great durability, he does have his limits, and if he takes too much damage, he will go down. Nero, too, is an 18-year-old young man, and although his official profile states that he, too, is a half-human, half-demon hybrid, I do not agree that Nero carries many properties of a demon. During his upbringing, it is clear that Nero has kept himself in prime physical conditions, capable of keeping up with the movement of demons, and thanks to the demonic arm that Nero has, it does seem to allow his body to perform special physical traits far beyond that of a regular human. But I'm not willing to go so far as to say by much. Like Vergil, Nero really doesn't seem to have any prime weaknesses except the fact that he too has limited durability. And although he has much greater durability than the average human like you or me, he can only take so much before he goes down. Vergil and Nero are very similar in terms of physical capabilities, but in this case I would have to give the edge to Vergil. The reason being is that in terms of these two getting used to their enhanced demonic advantages, Vergil has had more time to develop his body to take advantage of his demonic physical enhancements. Vergil has spent his entire life building himself up to use his demonic advantages and therefore has had more experience at using them than Nero. This statement is also supported by the fact that when Vergil and Dante faced each other for the first time, it was clear that Vergil was the stronger of the two, since Vergil has spent his life embracing his demonic powers, while Dante did everything he could to hold back at using them, and only chose to take advantage of his demonic capabilities when he needed to. While Nero has proven that he is more than capable of keeping up with a hybrid like Vergil, since he did so well in his first engagement against Dante, I can't imagine that Nero is very effective with this capability since he's only had them for a day. So although Nero can certainly keep up with Vergil for a time, in a physical sense, there is no doubt that Vergil completely outclasses Nero. Edge, Vergil. Although Vergil was a very highly trained swordsman in his own right, his list of special abilities were quite limited, but highly developed. Vergil had the ability to summon energy swords that were highly accurate and could cause great deals of damage to opponents. They also had various uses that Vergil could take advantage of. Vergil could choose to fire them at an opponent with rapid firing cessation. He could also summon numerous swords at once and fire them all at the same time. He could also use these energy swords in a very defensive manner by summoning a series of swords around his body to damage anyone that got close to him. Vergil also had the ability to channel his own demonic energy into all his weapons, enabling them to cause even more damage to his opponents in a series of different ways. However, Vergil's most powerful ability was the use of his Devil Trigger. This ability allowed Vergil to transform his body completely to his demon form, and in this form, it highly enhanced all of his physical capabilities in terms of speed, durability, and strength, and he also had the ability to heal his body in combat. However, this ability is not completely foolproof and could only last for a few moments, and once the transformation was done, Vergil would be momentarily vulnerable to attacks. Before I begin, I would just like to state right now that due to the nature of this particular versus matchup, Nero will not have access to the Yamato sword for obvious reasons. That being said, Nero too was a skilled swordsman in his own right, but he too was even more limited in his special abilities. Due to the fact that all of his special abilities were limited to the use of his demonic arm, dubbed the Devilbringer. In short, the Devilbringer was nothing more than a glorified grappling hook. With the use of the Devilbringer, Nero could grab enemies at a distance and pull them close to him, or in vice versa, he could grab enemies and pull himself to them. He could also use his devil bringer arm to rip demons apart or grab an enemy and bang them across the ground like a rag doll. Nero could also use the demonic power of his arm to channel energy through his revolver. However, this technique requires time to charge and can only be fired with one shot at a time. Between Vergil and Nero, they are both very limited in their arsenal of special abilities, but in this contest I would have to give the edge to Vergil, but not by much. The reason being is that Vergil's arsenal is a bit more flexible and all have a series of various uses. Vergil's energy swords can be used as both an offensive and defensive tool. Vergil's devil trigger also gives him a number of enhancement advantages that Nero would have much difficulty countering. However, I won't put Nero down too much because it has been shown that although Nero's Devilbringer arm is a very limited tool, it has been used to be a quite flexible in a series of different scenarios against a large variety of different opponents. And even if Vergil chose to use his Devil Trigger, I do believe Nero's Devilbringer arm would still be an effective tool if Nero could catch him. But that is only if Nero could catch him. However, Vergil most likely has spent more time developing his special abilities and how best to use them to get the maximum results, while Nero has only just started to get to use his powers. So although Nero is a very skilled user of his abilities, he has not mastered them to the level that Vergil has, and it is for these reasons that I give the special abilities edge to Vergil. In terms of armament, Vergil will be bringing three different weapons into this particular matchup, his primary weapon being dubbed the Yamato Sword, which once belonged to his father Sparda. The sword is of katana design with an organic bronze guard, and although Yamato seems like a katana, it is said to be able to cut through anything and is even sharper than any Japanese blade. It is also embedded with tremendous magic, and it is a fact that it is the only weapon shown to be capable of damaging Nero's Devilbringer arm. Vergil also carries the Beowulf, which is a set of flash gauntlets and greaves that Vergil received after defeating Beowulf the Light Beast. The Beowulf multiplies the amount of physical damage the user can deal to their opponent, and Vergil's fighting form when using this weapon seems to resemble some form of up-close kickboxing fighting techniques, but I'm unable to identify which form. Vergil's third and final weapon is dubbed the Force Edge, which is the second sword that also belonged to his father Sparda. It looks like just any regular blade, however, the Force Edge's true powers were sealed away by the Dark Knight Sparda, and Vergil received this sword temporarily after he and his brother defeated Archimonde in Devil May Cry 3. The Force Edge seems to be of heavy-duty design and meant to be used for heavy power blows, much like Dante's Rebellion Sword. And it is also known that Vergil can use the Force Edge sword alongside the Yamato sword to resemble a Jarkai style of fighting. Nero too will be bringing three weapons of his own into this matchup, the first being his main long-range weapon dubbed the Blue Rose. The Blue Rose is a uniquely designed revolver with an over and under barrel style. This design allows it to fire two magnum rounds with each pull of the trigger. Nero can use his own demonic energy to charge up a shot with the Blue Rose, allowing each round fired to cause even more damage. Nero's main sword is dubbed the Red Queen. It's a customizable version of the blades used by the Order of Swords, and it was designed by Agnes. It's not a devil arm, but its unique construction makes it just as powerful. It is also specifically customized with a motorcycle-like gear shift, which when pulled, sprays a flammable propellant across the blade and opponent, causing great damage. Nero's third weapon is dubbed the Devilbringer. The Devilbringer is Nero's right arm and the physical manifestation of his own demonic power. The arm possesses superhuman strength, which can also manifest through a large spectral arm, and this arm can do feats of supernatural strength which Nero often uses to his advantage when fighting demons. Dante himself admitted that in terms of sheer brute strength, Nero might be even stronger than himself. In combat, the arm is mostly used to pull enemies towards Nero or him towards them. He can also use the Devilbringer in up-close combat to punch enemies or to rip them apart. When comparing both Vergil's and Nero's armament, I find it quite interesting that both of them carry weapons that leaves them prepared for just about any scenario. In terms of swords, Vergil carries both the Yamato and the Force Edge, which both can channel Vergil's own demonic energy and are the very weapons that belong to the Dark Knight Sparda, and can be used in a number of uses which include heavy power strikes with the Force Edge, as long as long-range slashes with the Yamato. While Nero carries the Red Queen, which too has a number of uses, and the motorcycle gear shift gives the weapon some mechanical properties that have been proven to be highly effective against demons. Vergil carries the Beowulf gauntlets and greaves, which can cause extreme damage, but Vergil would need to get really close in order to make these weapons effective. While Nero has the Blue Rose Revolver, which is his main prime weapon for long-range attacks, and Nero's Devilbringer arm can be used for both long-range as well as close-range attacks, unfortunately, I'm unable to decide which combatant has the better array of weapons. Vergil has speed and power in his corner, while Nero has variety and the unique properties of the Devilbringer arm, which is no doubt could be effective against Vergil if Nero could get his hands on him. And for these reasons, no edge will be given in terms of weapons. In terms of combat capabilities and battle tactics, Vergil would be a top-grade master in my opinion, remaining to be on par if not exceeding his brother's level of skills as a swordsman even later on into his life. Vergil's own fighting style was dubbed Dark Slayer, which was designed on focusing on using well-timed power strikes to deliver the maximum amount of damage, along with using specialized evasion movements to either dodge an opponent's attacks or to block and immediately counterattack. Like in all my previous Versus series matchups involving sword users, if I had to compare Vergil's own fighting maneuvers and techniques to lightsaber fighting forms, I believe the three forms Vergil would specialize in would be Form 2 Makashi, Form 5 Shien or the Gemso, and Form 6 Naiman. He would use Makashi with the use of his Yamato sword, and would use this form, which was designed for blade-on-blade combat and relied on speed and precision strikes. He would use Form 5 Shien or the Gemso with the use of both his Yamato sword or his Force Edge Blade, in which this form was designed to block projectiles and fire them right back at the shooter, along with in combat relying on block and immediately counterattacking, and would use Form 6 Naiman, which opens the door for dual sword wielding, along with allowing a user to incorporate the use of force powers within their fighting maneuvers, or within Vergil's case, the use of demonic powers. Vergil's only real weakness in terms of his own tactics is that he is much stronger when he does not rely on full-out offensives, but if he is frustrated enough or takes enough damage, he can be tempted to fall into the state of mind, which makes him painfully predictable and open to making mistakes that his opponents can and will take advantage of. The only one who's ever been able to achieve this was his brother Dante, but I'm sure anyone would be frustrated or even annoyed if you had to fight the same person three different times in one day. Nero was a highly trained combatant, so much so that it was believed that Nero was one of the best fighters within the Order of Swords. However, due to his youthful personality and his need to dominate any opponent regardless of whether he was facing one opponent or swarms of enemies, Nero's fighting style had to be based on the notion that the best defense was an overwhelming offense. The prime lightsaber fighting form that Nero would clearly specialize in is Form 7 Zhuyan, with a Makashi-like mentality of only using one arm with his blade. Zhuyan is the most demanding of all lightsaber fighting forms and relies completely on dominating your opponent with overwhelming force, or in Nero's case, overwhelming firepower. Zhuyan also plays off the emotions of the user and requires the user to attack with passion. This form also plays on the notion that one must enjoy the thrill of battle, and this mentality perfectly describes Nero. He either blasts you away with his Blue Rose Magnum, cuts you to pieces with his Red Queen sword, or literally pounds you into the ground and rips you apart with his Devilbringer arm. I'm even willing to go so far as to state that out of all the main set of characters throughout the Devil May Cry franchise, Nero was by far the most aggressive. The only prime weakness that Nero had within his own maneuvers is that Nero's own fighting style did not provide any sort of defense, but instead he had to rely on evasion. He also had extreme difficulties with opponents that could move exceptionally fast. He could also find difficulties either trying to shoot down fast-moving opponents or trying to get a grip on them with his Devilbringer arm. Finally, Nero's fighting style was very straightforward and predictable, as it was shown during Nero's second fight against Dante. While Nero was able to surprise Dante and defeat him during their first engagement, once Dante knew all of Nero's combative capabilities, he could easily develop maneuvers that caught Nero off guard, leading to his defeat. What I find really surprising when it comes to comparing Vergil and Nero's battle tactics against each other is the fact that they are complete opposites when it comes to their links to demonic powers. Vergil is a pure human slash demon hybrid, and although he has a higher rate of demonic power, he uses it rather conservatively and precise. While Nero has very limited access to demonic powers, but fights like a raging psycho and more like a demon. And between these two, it is clear that Vergil has the advantage. Vergil has spent more time developing his combat skills and taking advantage of all the benefits that his demonic powers allow him, which is something Dante tried to avoid leading up to their first battle against each other. Vergil also has the advantage of his Devil Trigger to enhance his own combat effectiveness, along with being able to chain multiple different attacks together. Compared to Vergil, Nero is nothing more but a much more aggressive version of Dante at the beginning of Devil May Cry 3. Just like Dante, Nero is a skilled warrior who has a small set of combat capabilities and knows how to use them effectively against most opponents, but when it comes to facing an opponent who has had even more time and experience to develop his combat capabilities and is more capable of countering all of Nero's techniques, you'll see that Nero's tactics are far too predictable and capable for Vergil to deal with. Nero could fire off his gun as much as he wants or try to go head-to-head with his sword, and as we've all seen, Vergil can handle these techniques just as he did in his first engagement against Dante. The only real standout tactic that Nero has in his corner is the use of his Devil Bringer arm, and even Dante was able to find a way to get around it. And if Dante could get around it, there is no doubt that Vergil would have an easier time getting around it as well. Bottom line, in terms of battle tactics, Nero doesn't have anything Vergil couldn't handle, and it is for these reasons that Vergil gets the edge in battle tactics. A fight between these two prominent characters of the Devil May Cry franchise would be a very quick ordeal, but at the end of the day, there is no question that Vergil would win the fight flawlessly. Nero cannot compete with Vergil physically because although he may have access to demonic physical advantages, Vergil has spent his entire life embracing his demonic side and therefore has trained his body to have it work for him. Nero's use of demonic power is also very limited to compare to Vergil's, who has a series of different powers and techniques that not only have various uses in combat, but can be linked together to create an unmatched level of overwhelming offensive capabilities. Although both Vergil and Nero are equally flexible when it comes to their array of weapons that they can bring into combat, it's within their battle tactics and how each of them will approach a fight that ultimately would secure Vergil's victory. The bottom line is that Nero is simply bringing nothing to this fight that Vergil would have little difficulties dealing with. The only tool that Nero has that stands out is, once again, his Devil Bringer arm, and even this is something Vergil could have no difficulties against. This fight would play out in a very similar fashion to Dante's first fight against Vergil in Devil May Cry 3. Nero would start off by firing his Blue Rose revolver at Vergil, but Vergil would simply counter by rotating his Yamato sword and firing Nero's bullets right back at him. And whether or not they hit him doesn't really matter. What matters is that Nero realizes that his Blue Rose revolver will not help him very much in this fight. Nero would then charge at Vergil going for a total offense, but Vergil would simply channel his demonic energy through the Yamato sword and slash at Nero at a distance, which is something Nero has never seen before, knocking him to the ground. Now Nero would get really angry, noticing that Vergil is not even trying, and resorts to using his Devil Bringer arm, which is something Vergil has never seen before, and would pull Vergil up close to him so he could resort to using his Red Queen sword, but Vergil would immediately summon his circle of swords, knocking Nero back. Nero would once again resort to using his Devil Bringer arm in an attempt to grab Vergil and cause some sort of physical damage, but this time Vergil would be prepared and would then begin using his Dark Slayer fighting style and would begin teleporting from spot to spot, making it very difficult for Nero to gain a grip on Vergil. And it is during Nero's attempt to grab Vergil using his Devil Bringer arm that Vergil would teleport to the side of Nero while his Devil Bringer arm is extended and would amputate Nero's Devil Bringer arm clean off with his Yamato sword, which is the one weapon designed to cut through anything. Nero, now in shock after losing his arm, would drop to his knees, and it is here that Vergil would pull out his force-edged sword and impale Nero right through the heart, pinning him down to the ground. And knowing that a simple impalement through the chest won't entirely kill Nero, Vergil would pull out his Yamato sword one last time and decapitate Nero's head right off, putting him down permanently. The sad thing about this fight is the simple fact that Vergil would not even need to use a good portion of his combat capabilities to defeat Nero. He wouldn't need to fire off his summoning swords as an offensive weapon. He wouldn't need to use his Beowulf gauntlets. He wouldn't even need to use his Devil Trigger to enhance his own combat effectiveness. If Vergil had chosen to fight in a total offensive tactic as he did in his third fight against Dante, he would simply overwhelm Nero, since it has been shown that even though Nero's only real battle tactic is to go on a total offense, if he encounters an opponent that can bring even more offensive power against Nero, Nero has no defensive tactics to fall back on and would have to rely on simply evading, and with Vergil's speed alone, he would be unable to dodge Vergil's attacks. As a one-time engagement, Nero would simply be walking into a fight he has no chance of winning. Now, to give Nero some credit, I do believe it is possible for Nero to beat Vergil if he engaged him enough times to the point where Nero could get familiar with all of Vergil's tactics and capabilities, which is the very reason that Dante was able to defeat Vergil, despite the fact that, in my opinion, Vergil was still the better fighter. But in this case, Nero would not get a second chance to take on Vergil, and it is for these reasons that I am giving the win to the Son of Sparda, Vergil. Oh man, I'm really sorry guys for the long wait. If you've been following my channel, you would know that I've been going through a lot of problems these past 2 months. For starters, my capture card died, so I wasn't able to record the footage I wanted. I also moved back to Vegas, and I've been having a very difficult time finding time to work on this video. But now that I've got everything situated, I should be able to get these videos out faster. And please remember that this verdict for this particular versus matchup was my own personal opinion, and feel free to like, comment down below, and please subscribe to track me in my future versus series matchups. And like always, thank you guys for watching, and here's a sneak preview of my next versus series matchup.
If she wants a game, she'll get one. With the real Ada Wong.
Yeah, they both went after Wesker. He's on some tanker.